Hi, everyone. This is Don Smith for Cranford TV 35 Sports. We are on location at Jersey Lanes in Linden for an exciting matchup. We have varsity bowling for you here on TV 35 today. It is the Cranford Cougars against the Roselle Park Panthers. And joining me is Mike, our camera guy here. He's working the camera. I'm Don Smith. And we're just waiting for the match to start. So they have a 10-minute practice period here at Jersey Lanes. This is where all the teams bowl. If you're not familiar with bowling, again, I was on the Cranford bowling team many, 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 many moons ago. Let's not say how long ago that was, but all the schools bowl for all the different conferences all at the same time. So it's definitely a different situation than, let's say, basketball or wrestling or other volleyball or other sports. So we have, again, Cranford against Roselle Park. They're just warming up. Let me read you down the starting lineup for our five here. We have Nick Rett is our number one bowler. We have Ryan Rose is number two. We have Dylan. Oh, Dylan Amrose. Apologies for that. It was at the top of the list. And we have Will Town. And Mike Kisley. Kisley. Okay, so those are your top five. I apologize from our vantage point. From our vantage point, my bad eyes, I can't really tell what the actual names are on the scoreboard there. So I have the roster here in my hand, so I apologize for that. So again, we're just awaiting here on lanes 31 and 32 for our match to begin. Now, if you're unfamiliar with scoring, it's total pins wins the game. So then what they do is they'll get 2 points for each win and 1 point for total pins. So you can get a maximum of 7 points for the match. Cranford comes in at 6-4 for today's contest against the, again, Roselle Park Panthers. So Roselle Park, Cranford have a storied history in many, many different sports, especially wrestling throughout the years. So we're just awaiting here for the practice session to finish. That should be momentarily, and then we'll be underway here at Jersey Lanes. Thank you so much for dialing us up here on Cranford TV 35. Again, Don Smith along with Mikey here on the camera, bringing to you Cougar Varsity Sports on TV 35. I guess, Mike, we're missing our other broadcast partners, Mr. Kelly and Mr. Plick. But maybe for the next one, we'll see if Mr. Kelly or Mr. Plick can come out and join us for bowling. So as we continue to wait here for the practice session to end, again, it's a 10-minute practice session, and there's 2 minutes and 33 seconds left in the practice. Wow, what a far cry from my days of bowling for Cranford High School, where there was no automatic score. Well, there was, actually, at Echo Lanes, if anybody in the area remembers Echo Lanes in Mountainside. That was where we ended up bowling all of our matches. And now we're here again at Jersey Lanes, and unfortunately, there's not a whole lot of bowling centers around, but they are, looks to me like they're starting to make a little bit of a comeback. So there's some interesting, over the years, it's amazing how deliveries for bowling has changed so drastically. It's essentially not so much the form back in my day, but it's a matter of just whatever you can do with the ball, basically. And what it can do to the pins is kind of the space that we're in now. I mean, some of the deliveries here are, you know, back in the day would have been completely unorthodox, is what we called it back then. But, you know, some of these young student athletes are really not even using the thumb. They're just using the two fingers. So we got a minute left for a big contest here. Mike, you getting excited?
Yes.
All right. That's a resounding yes to Mikey. All right, 50 seconds left here. And as full disclosure, I will do my best to try to call Roosevelt Park as well. Again, it's a little difficult to see from the vantage point that we have the actual overhead screens here. So we will do our best. So again, Cranford is coming in at 6-4. Again, we're just waiting for their first match to start. Cougars against the Panthers here at Jersey Lanes on lanes 31 and 32. We welcome you to Cranford Cougar Varsity Sports here on TV 35. So we're wrapping up the practice session here in about 10 seconds. So this should be the last practice ball. And that should do it. That is the end of the practice session. So we also have to make a note that we are only covering the varsity side of things. The varsity is here on 31, 32, 33, and 34 are the JV teams. So I believe that now we do the... All the teams come back for a little strategy session here at this point. So it's a bit of a staggered start, per se, to when teams came in and are actually here. Some of the schools take a little longer to get to Jersey Lanes. So that coach is giving them some last-minute instructions. There's the huddle here for the Cougars. There we go.
1, 2, 3,
all right, there we go. So they're getting all excited here as the Cougars getting ready for some action against Roselle Park. So our first bowler is Nick Rett. So here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4!
So Roselle Park getting ready. And here we go, Mikey. This is it. We've been waiting for this one all season, Mike. This is it. Bringing you bowling here on Cranford TV 35. And the first shot by Nick Rett. A little left of the head pin. Gets 7. So we started off here. The 1-3-8, 1-3-9 split. It's not a split, pardon me. But he's got the double wood behind it, so he's got to cover both pins with the ball. So let's see what Nick does here. Nice pickup there by Nick Rett. So your leadoff bowler, Nick Rett, comes in with a 7 spare. Our next bowler is Ryan Rose for the Cougars here on lane 31. If you're unfamiliar bowling, you do a little bit of a courtesy to either side. He's a lefty. Comes a little bit wide of the pocket. Leaves himself the 1-2. So here's the second shot, and just a little bit wide of the spare, so that's an open frame here for the Cougars. He goes 8 and out. So next up is Dylan Amrose. Fairly vocal in the huddle. Let's see what Dylan can do here. Nice looking shot, a little bit wide of the pocket. Picks up 6. 1-2-4-8 are left. Again, he's got the double wood behind it. getting some last-minute instructions from Coach Feely. So let's see what Dilla can do to pick up the spare. That's a nice shot. Looks like he's going to cover everything. Yeah, there you go. All right, so the Cougars pick up a spare here in the third position. And Will Town is up next for the Cougars. Got some nice roll on that. Hits the head pin, leaves himself the mini split. So he leaves himself the 3-10 split. So let's see what Will can pick up here. See if he's going to hang in there. Slides by the three and heads. Takes out the 10, so an open frame here for the Cougars. And Mike Kisley is up next. He is the anchor for the Cougars. Again, just getting you familiar with some of the terminology. You know, the fifth bowler is usually the anchor. And that's the unconventional style, which is very popular today. Certainly got a lot of spin on the ball there. And again, is not only a little tough to tell from this vantage point, but he actually has he does not have his fingers in the ball at all. So he's basically just kind of shoving the ball down the lane. That's an open frame for the Cougars now. So after one frame, Cougars are up 46-37. Roselle Park, we're still waiting for their anchor bowler to go ahead here on lane 32. And then what they'll do is they'll alternate lanes. That was a nice strike by Roselle Park. So after one frame here, Panthers are up 47-46. So now what they're going to do is they'll switch over to 32. So Nikki Rhett is up here for the Cougars. And here we go, Mike on 32. Oh, solid pocket hit. Comes up with a 9. Leaves the 4 pin. So Mike Rhett has a spare, working spare in the first. He's got 19. Too bad I couldn't somehow get the scoreboard, Mikey, into the broadcast. I don't know how we could do that. So Rhett opens up here in the second frame. So he's got 28 through 2. And next up is Ryan Rose. Solid 1-2 pocket strike. Nice shot by Ryan Rose here in the second. Next up is Dylan Amrose here on 32. If you hear some commotion and whatnot on the closest to us, we have Roselle, and it looks like, not sure who's gonna be bowling. They're gonna be bowling, but they're having some trouble with the lanes here, so that's why there's a little bit more of a little activity off to the one side. Comes up a little solid on the head pin, and he leaves the 4 pin. Again, you're watching Cougar Varsity Sports here on Cranford TV 35. This is Cranford Varsity Bowling here at Jersey Lanes. Don Smith, oh, Mikey, our camera operator here, bringing all the action on lanes 31 and 32. Nice pickup there by Ambrose. So he's got 2 spares in a row. Nice start for Dylan. So Will Town is up next. Let's see what he can do here after the split and the open frame. Nice, solid pocket shot by Town. So Town comes back after the split in the first, has a strike in the second. Mike Kisley is up next. So let's see what Mike can do here. So as it stands, the Cougars are up 27, but Roselle Park is only in their third bowler at this point. So here comes Kisley again with that nice solid strike there. And again, you saw that mixing action as the ball progressed down the lane, puts a lot of heavy rotation, heavy spin. And we're seeing more and more of that, that kind of shovel kind of pushing of the ball. Years ago, that would be certainly unconventional in every way, shape, and form. But it's become more of the commonplace as a lot of the PBA bowlers have been, more in tune to different methods of delivery. So now what's happening here is we're just waiting for Roselle Park to finish up their second frame. As you can see, this young man here from Roselle Park, he's got that shovel type delivery as well. So Cranford is had a really nice frame there. Three strikes to spare and open. So that's almost like a reverse, it's almost like a shovel, kind of a reverse spin. Very interesting. Again, friends, it's been a long time since I've really been in a bowling house to begin with, let alone bowled. But, you know, back in the day, the most unconventional delivery method was the great Mark Getchberg for Cranford High School, who bowled off the wrong foot. If you know anything about bowling, he was a right-handed bowler and would end off on his right foot where normally you would end off on your left foot. And at that point, that was, again, very unconventional in the delivery method. And, that has nothing on what we're seeing here today. So we're just waiting for Roselle Park to finish here in the second frame. So again, if you're unfamiliar with bowling, they switch alternate lanes here. So now Cranford has to wait until Roselle Park is finished with the second frame. So here we go, we got Nick Rett. Nicky's coming up here in the third frame. He's coming off an open frame. He's got 28 through two. That's a nice shot there in the pocket. Leaves the five. So sometimes what you will see is that with that straight shot, the ball hits the pins and then physics takes over and then the ball is just going to kind of deflect to the right. So it just missed getting the five pin. So let's see if Nick can do that same shot again, and he should have a spare. That looked like it slipped off his fingers just a little bit. So Rett opens up in the third. He's got 37. And we've got Rose is up next working on a strike. So right now as it stands, Roselle Park is up nine now. This is an important shot here. Already early in the match for Rose. If he can double up here. So he gets a little mixing action. Hits on the Brooklyn side, as they would call it, right? So he leaves the two pin. Here on lane 31. Actually bowling next to us is the Roselle Rams. So here we go with Rose for the spare. And yep, that's all you gotta do is just touch it, knock it down. So it's a nice pickup there by Rose in the third. He's got 28 through two working on the nine spare in the third frame. So Amrose is up next. He's working on a nine spare in the second. So here we go. Here's Dylan's first shot. Nice looking shot in the pocket. Solid strike for Dylan Amrose. So that was a big shot right there. That pretty much brings us all square through halfway through the third frame. So Town is up next, working on a strike. This is a key shot already here in the third frame. Again, you want to capitalize on the strikes that you're able to throw to double up. Let's see what happens here. Nice looking shot there. Good, solid pocket strike for Will Town. He doubles up here in the third. That was a key shot. Takes the Cougars ahead by 17 now. Here comes Kisley. So let's see what Mike can do here. Working on a strike in the second. Nice, oh, solid shot. Leaves a solid 10. And I find it interesting, you know, with these young bowlers, when they have these heavy spin, heavy curved shots, and how they make the 10 pin. See if he flattens it out straighter. Puts a little more speed on it, switch balls, and just slid off into the channel. So he opens up here. So Cranford's up by 25 going into the fourth frame. Now again, we're just waiting for the anchor for Roselle Park to finish it. His fourth frame, third frame. He puts up a solid strike there. So now Cougars are up 15 going into the fourth. We're almost halfway through the midpoint of this first match. Again, you're watching Cougar Varsity Sports on Cranford TV 35. We are at Jersey Lanes for Cougar Bowling. And Rhett has a hits on the opposite side. Or as we used to say, on the O. And he leaves himself a 10 pin. Let's see if Nick can come back after the two opens in the second and third. So let's see what Nicky can do here. And flatten it out just a little bit. So it's three open frames here for Nick Rhett. That's 46 through four. And Rose will be up next, working on a nine spare. And that pretty much almost brings us square. Our only lefty in the group. Nice spinning action there. Ball had nice rotation on it. And he leaves the five pin. So Ryan Rose. That's 47. And just waiting to see if he can convert on the five pin spare. So let's see what Rose can do here. He can pick this up. This will be a key pickup. And he does, picks up the five. So Rose has three marks in a row, nine spare. He's got 47 working in the third. So Amrose is up next. This is a key shot. If he can double up here, that will bring the Cougars ahead for just this point, but setting up a foundation here. So here we go. Here's Dylan Amrose in the fourth. Good looking follow through. Comes a little left of the pocket and the head pin. Leaves himself the 1-3-6. So the 1-3-6 is left for Dylan Amrose here in the fourth. Let's see if he can pick this up. Here's Amrose in a second shot. Lane 32. Good follow through, nice roll, picks up the spare. Nice spare there by Amrose here in the fourth. And here's Will Town, who can really help out the Cougars here. who could certainly help out the Cougars with a triple, gets the turkey. And Mikey, if Town gets the strike, you got to zoom into the screens. Hopefully they put the turkey up. We'll see. So here we go. Will Town working, going for the triple. Good looking roll. Came up a little heavy on the head pin. And he is going to leave the 4-6-7. So, you know, the angle of attack here that you'd go, Roosevelt Park here on 31, beautiful shot there, beautiful, all 10 pins in the pit. The idea would be to slide the four, ricochet it off the side wall, and then it takes out the seven, and then comes across and takes out the six. Let's see what happens. Good attempt. So we got one there. So he opens up. He's got 62 through four. Cougars still ahead by five. Although Roselle Park put up three marks, and their anchor is working on a double. So here's Kisley coming up in the fourth. Good rotation, way out, hits the head pin. So he's going to be left with a relatively easy spare, the three pin. So now Nick Rett is here on 31. They want to keep the match moving. And Rett picks up eight after three consecutive opens. So let's see if Nicky here can come up with a spare, gain some confidence. Nice nine spare there by Kisley in the anchor position. So as it stands now, we have the Cougars up by 23, but Roselle Park, their lead bowler, is working on a double. Nice spare there by Rett. So Rett comes up with a spare. A little bit of a confidence builder there for Nicky with three opens in a row. So this is a key shot here for Roselle Park as well. Let's see what Rose can do here. Nice look, good looking delivery, nice shot. Oh, at least he got rid of the split. So leaves himself a fairly easy seven pin. Here's Roselle Park. This is the key shot, working on a double. Solid 10. So that's going to help out the Cougars there that he was unable to triple up. So here is Rose now working on a nine spare, 66 in the fourth. Easily picks up the seven pin. Nice solid spare there for Rose. So Amrose is up next for the Cougars. And Roselle Park, their lead bowler, just opened here in the fifth. We're coming off the double, so that's certainly going to work in the Cougars' favor. Cougars up by 17 now here in this first match. So let's see what Amrose can do here in the fifth as we go halfway through this first game. Good looking roll. Crosses over and leaves himself the five pin. And that was at 10.6 miles per hour. So they're actually keeping speed. So let's see what Amrose can do here, if he can pick up the spare. He's having a clean game, coming off the seven spare in the fourth. So let's see what Dylan can put together here in the fifth. Slides off a little bit to the left. And so Amrose opens up here. He's got 87 through five. Still Cougars are ahead by 15. Now Town is up after coming off the split. And the eight open there, 62 in the fourth. It's the head pin again, identical. It's the identical split as it was in the fourth frame. The 4-6-7. Again, you're looking for a little luck and taking that four pin off the sidewall, and it slices off the seven and comes back and takes out the six. Let's see what Will can do. Nice looking roll. That's the way to go for it. So he opens up again, nine and out with 71 in the fifth. So here comes Kisley. Here in the fifth. Way outside. Good mixing strike there. So a nice strike there, pick himself up after the open in the third. So Mikey's got 57 working a strike in the fifth. So as it stands, Cougars are up by 24 here going into the sixth frame. Mikey, thanks. Just wanted to talk to the coach for a second. All right, so Cougars are up. I don't know what happened here with the scores. Oh, so we're waiting for Roselle Park to finish out the fifth frame. So nice spare by Roselle Park in the fifth. So Cougars are now down by four, heading into the sixth. So Nick Red is up here. So Nick Red up on 32 for the sixth frame. Nice mixing strike there. So there we go. Cougars now have two strikes in a row coming out of the fifth into the sixth. That was a big key shot. Puts the Cougars up by 16. Let's see what Rose can do here in the sixth. Working on a nine spare. Nice looking shot. Looking for some mix off the right sidewall. Leaves himself the mini bucket. The 3-5-6. So this should be a relatively easy spare for Ryan, being a lefty coming in. Be able to take out that double wood with the three and the six. So here we go. And he picks up one. Slid past it just a little bit to the left. Trying to figure out the oil pattern. Now again, there's gonna be a lot more oil here in this first game than there will be, let's say, halfway through the third match, as the oil will start to break down. So Amrose is up here in the sixth. Nice looking shot. A little heavy on the head pin again, and he leaves himself the 6-10. And again, if you're unfamiliar with bowling, you know, many of our young bowlers here, they have several different bowling balls for different types of conditions. Some switch off on a first shot and a spare ball. Sometimes a spare ball would be more of a plastic ball that would not curve as much. So Amrose opens up here in the sixth at 95. Cougars are down nine here. And again, getting back to the oil patterns, you know, like I said, if things start to break down as the lanes start to heat up and so forth. And again, back in my day, it was probably people smoking and cigarette smoke and everything else. It was bedlam. But I mean, so thankfully we don't have to deal with that here. But, you know, that also was a contributing factor way, way back in the day. So let's see what Town can do. Nice crossover strike. So coming off of two opens, Town strikes there. That was a key shot. Cougars are now down 18 as Roselle Park has marked in the first three positions in the sixth frame. This young man throws almost a backup ball. Interesting. So let's see what Kisley can do. Way out to the channel. That one got away from Mikey just a little bit. He was probably hitting boards three and four maybe, and then went way out to one and two, and then just didn't have enough time for it to come back into the 1-3 pocket. So leaves himself, has a seven. Here's Kisley with the spare attempt. Just trimmed off that four pin. So he opens up after the strike with a nine. So let's do a little game reset now. Cougars are down 19 going into the seventh frame. Here's Nick Rett up on lane 31. Good looking mixing strike, crosses over again. So he doubles up, so that's a really key shot here for the Cougars. Basically all square now. And that was Owen Miller for the Panthers, just struck there. He's got a double as the first bowler. Here comes Rose, he's up next. Crosses over just a little bit, leaves himself a solid four pin. Camilla Cordero for Roselle Park is up next, and she's working. She's having a really nice game, 85 through 5, working on seven spare into the seventh. So here's Rose. His last shot was 13.2 miles per hour. And he picks up the spare. So it was a nice spare there. Again, we're in a real close match here. Cougars down nine. Here's Cordero, leaves herself a split after five consecutive marks. So now Cougars are down 25 with Amrose working in the seventh. Nice looking roll there, gonna cross over, looking for a little help off the sideboard. Leaves the six pin. So Cordero opens up there with a split. Here comes Amrose, nice looking spare. Good looking cover there for Dylan. That was a key shot. Cougars down 16. Caitlin Nickel looks like she's up next for the Panthers. So here's Town. Hit the head pin just a little bit flush. He's going to leave himself the 4-7. So Cougars now down 16. And chop the three off the six there. So here's Town. He's going to cover there with the spare. Here's Derek Wernoski for Roselle Park. Solid, solid strike there. All 10 pins in the pit for that young man. All right, so we got Mike Kisley here for the Cougars coming up. Let's see if he can keep the drive alive. Way out to boards five and six. Solid, all 10 pins in the pit for Mikey. So that was a clean frame by the Cougars. Still down 13, but Rett is working on a double. Another solid shot by Roselle Park. I believe it's Michael Martins. Again, the names come up fairly quickly on top, so I apologize to our Roselle Park viewers. Just trying to grab it very quickly. All right, friends, so this is the game reset. Cougars down 33 going into the eighth, but Nick Rett is working on a double. This is the key shot in the match right here. If he can triple up, he comes up with eight. So that brings the deficit to just 9. He's got the 2-5 left. Owen Miller up here for Roselle Park sends that one wide and gets a little help off the sideboard. Trips out the head pin for the Turkey. That was a key shot for the Panthers. They go up 39 in the match. Here's Rhett with his spare attempt. He chops off the 2 off the 5. And that can happen. It's a little deceiving from the way it looks. You almost have to throw it as if your first shot. So here we go with Rose working on a 9 spare. Nice spinning, a lot of spin on that. Leaves himself the 6 pin. So solid shot there by Camilla Cordero for the Panthers. That was another key shot. Cougars down 29 with Rose shooting spare in the 8th. Nice cover there. So every spare counts here now, friends. Every spare, every mark counts. So let's see what Ambrose can do here, working on the 9th spare in the 7th. So let's see what Ambrose can do here. Good looking follow through, a lot of mix action. He's gonna leave himself a single 9 pin. Caitlin here for Panthers picks up her spare. So here's Ambrose for the spare. This is a key mark, good follow through, nice cover. So Cougars are down 19. Solid strike by Wernoski for Roselle Park. That had a lot of power on that shot. That said 13.7 miles per hour. So here we go, Will Town in the 8th. Good looking, kicks out the 8 pin for the strike. That was a big strike right there. Big strike. So the Cougars are down 19. So here we go, Mike Kisley working on a strike. Another key shot here for the Cougars. Can he get another, try to work the magic again on the O, but leaves himself the 8 pin. Pardon me, the 9 pin. So here's Michael Martins for the Panthers, having a nice game himself. Here comes Kisley, picks up the spare. All right, so Cougars down 17 pending this spare attempt by Martins from Roselle Park. Nice cover there by the young man. So let's do the game reset here. Going into the 9th, the foundation 9th, Cougars are down by 19 with Nick Rhett. Looking to put a little bit of a run for the Cougars here as the leadoff bowler in the 9th. Hits on the Brooklyn side there and leaves himself the 5-9 spare. So let's see what Rhett can do. That one looked like it just slipped off his finger, slipped out of his hand just a little bit. So Rhett opens up here in the 9th. Cougars down 35 now. You don't want to get yourself too far in a hole to dig yourself out of. Solid mixing strike there. Little kiss off the side. As the great Bill Raftery says, the kiss. So we've got Amrose up here. Nine spare in the eighth. Still down 19. I'm waiting for Cordero to set her first shot up in the ninth on 32. We're here on 31. Good follow through, good roll, crosses over. Can't trip out the double wood. Looking at the 3-9. Here's Cordero with her first shot. And she has a split. So Cougars are down 17 now. Rose struck in the foundation ninth. Let's see if Amrose can spare. Can he mark in the foundation as well? Good looking follow through. Let's see if it covers both. Yeah, very nice. Very nice spare there by Amrose. So Will Town is up next. This, I know you keep hearing me saying that every shot is the key shot, but this one definitely is the key shot. If Town can double up here, as Cordero opens up here in the ninth. Let's see what Town can do. Throws that ball way outside. Just doesn't have enough time to bring it back into the pocket. Leaves himself the bucket. And this is a tough spare because you got that double wood behind it. You got to cover the pins with the ball. So here's Town with the spare attempt. Nice looking cover there. Good looking spare for the Cougars. They're down 17 now. So here comes the Cougar anchor, Kisley, working on a 9 spare, hoping to set himself up in the foundation frame for a strike. Good looking ripping strike there, just shredded the deck. So Kisley strikes here in the ninth. Cougars are up 2 in Roselle Park. Gronowski just went through the head pin, leaves himself a very difficult split. The 4-6-7-9. That is an odd looking split. You don't see that very many times. So let's see how they play it. At this point, being this close in the match, only up 10, you definitely want to go for to at least get 2. Let's see what happens. That was a good attempt. He does the right thing, gets the 2. So opens up there. Now Michael Martins, who's having a real nice game, looking to set himself up in the foundation frame. Cougars down 12, pending the ninth frame shot by Martins. Boy, this young bowler is a really good-looking shot. Real smooth, real great delivery. Leaves himself a 10-pin. So Cougars down 30 now. Good-looking spare shooter, too. When you have that high arcing curve and you're able to do that and come back with the spare. Some good fundamentals by that young man. So all right, so let's set it up here for the 10th. Cougars down 31 in this first game. And Rhett is on 32 for the first shot, solid strike. So that's a good start to the 10th frame for the Cougars. Owen Miller answers with his own solid strike. Owen Miller is having a really nice game here. He may be the high bowler for both squads. Let's see what Nick Redd can do. He picks up 7. So let's see if Nick, again, every pin counts here, friends. Every mark counts. Here's Miller again, another solid strike. Doubles it up here in the 10th. Cougars down 44. And whether that could be the dagger, we'll see what happens. But so Rhett picks up two. So Nicky Rhett ends up with 149. Cougars down 42 now. Owen Miller looking to triple up in the 10th. So Owen Miller has a really nice 222 game. Here comes Rose on his first shot in the 10th. Leaves himself the 139. Not an easy spare again, friends. Just you have to cover both pins with the ball. Here's Cordero for Roselle Park. Solid, all 10 pins in the pit there. So Cougars down 46. Here's Rose with the spare attempt. Nice cover there by Ryan Rose. So he'll have one more. And Cougars down 40 now. So Ryan Rose giving courtesy there to Camilla Cordero for Roselle Park. Good looking sweeping shot. Comes across into the head pin. So here is Ryan Rose in his 10th. Picks up 10 there. So Rose finishes at 170. Now Dylan Amrose is up next, working on an 8 spare in the 9th. Working on an 8 spare in the 9th. Again, Cougars down 38. Every pin counts, friends. Every pin counts. Goes a little wide of the head pin. He'll leave himself the 139. So Cordero marks here in the 10th. With a strike, 8 spare. That puts her at 160. Cougars down just 26. Now this is certainly within grasp for the Cougars to take this one. They're going to need a couple of strikes in order to do it. So Amrose, beautiful spare there. Under pressure, that young man goes ahead and picks up a difficult spare. It's 7 spare. So Dylan Amrose has one more shot. Let's see what he can do. A strike here would be key, pick up another 10. All right, so Dylan Amrose is 7 spare 7. So that's a 166. For Amrose. All right, so Will Town is up next. Cougars down 34. Again, this is within grasp, especially with Kisley with a strike in the foundation 9th. Let's see Wernoski, let's see what he can do. Good looking shot, wow. Pins didn't have a chance. So here is Will Town, sends it way outside. It seems to be a popular spare there, the either the 259 or the 159. So now you got to cover both pins again with the ball. Here's Derek here for Roselle Park again. Comes up a little bit short, leaves the bucket. So Cougars down 30. That could have been the real the real final blow. And good-looking cover there by Will Town. Again, every mark counts here, friends. So let's see what Wernoski's going to do here on 31. Picks up the spare, so good cover there by Derek. Comes in with 132. Cougars down 37. So this is a key shot to bring it within striking distance for Kisley. So he picks up six, Town. So Cougars down 31 with our anchors getting ready to bowl. Here's Michael Martins, sends that ball way outside, rips, shreds the deck. Good looking shot there, and that may just about do it. If Kisley, he needs to strike. First ball in the 10th, has to strike to keep this in within striking distance, no pun intended. So let's see what Kisley can do. So Mike goes through the head pin there, leaves himself an 8 spare attempt. Cougars down 35. Wow. Michael Martins just is like, you know, use computer terms, thread ripping it. Here's Kisley. He goes by and misses the spare. So that's going to do it for the first game. Roselle Park's going to take it. We'll just have to see by how much. If Martins can go ahead and take the spare, the two pin. So Martins picks up the spare and Cougars lose by 45, 800 to 845. So here we go with match two. Let me just talk to camera guy here, Mikey. Mikey, what do you think of the first game here?
I think it's pretty interesting. I've never seen a competitive bowling match before, but I think it's pretty cool.
Pretty exciting, right? I mean, you can kind of keep yourself in the game right up until the end.
Exactly. I think it's very exciting.
Excellent. Thanks, Mike. So one question for you. Do you think we're doing that better? All right, Mikey, can you hear me? All right, here we go. I had to do a little battery change. So we're into the second match now. And I believe Cranford has a roster change. And we do have a roster change. So let's see here. This is Drew Schusterman is now in the leadoff position for the Cougars, picks up a 9 spare. So Rose is in second. Rhett comes down to 3. Town and Kisley rounded out for the Cougars here in the second game. So let's see what Rose can do now. If you're just joining us, this is Cougar Varsity Sports coverage on TV35 and on YouTube and all other social media platforms. Cranford TV35 Viabit. If you do that, that'll be the Viabit link to it. We'll put this up on YouTube as well. So Rose comes up with a nice 8 spare to start things off. Here comes Nicky Rhett in the third position. He started off the first game as the leadoff bowler. So Cougars lost the first game 845 to 800. So Rhett goes wide to the right. He's going to leave himself the 1-2-7. No, pardon me, 1-2-4. So let's see what Rhett can do here and if he can pick up the spare. Nice looking spare cover there by Rhett. In the first frame, So we're in early action as I was getting into the promotion for us here. Again, you're watching Cougar Varsity Sports on Cranford TV 35 as Will Town puts up a nice crossover strike here on TV 35. Don Smith, along with Mikey on the camera, doing a real nice job. Put your hands together and give a big applause to Mike here on the camera. We are here at Jersey Lanes on lanes 31 and 32 are our varsity bowlers. Junior varsity is on 33 and 34. Cougars are in a tough competition against the Roselle Park Panthers. And Roselle Park, always a potent foe for Cranford, especially in wrestling and here in bowling, and many of our other varsity athletics at Cranford High School. So Town struck here in the first. Kisley leaves himself a tough spare. So let's see what Kisley can do here to pick up this spare. Went a little bit wide to the right, almost picks it up. He goes nine and out. So here's Schusterman. He comes up into the first spot. He goes head pin there and leaves himself a nine spare. So Owen Miller gets himself a split. Let's see if Schusterman Drew here can pick up this spare. Good looking ball, nice cover. So Drew Schusterman comes up, takes over that first spot and has two consecutive marks. Next up is Ryan Rose in frame number two. Cougars up three, goes through the nose. Leaves himself the 247. I want to give a quick shout out to my good friend Tommy Tavallaro. I don't know if he'll be watching this. I'll have to send him a link, but me and Tommy did a lot of bowling back in the day with the old TV3 on the old Suburban Cablevision before Suburban Cablevision was sold to Comcast. If any of our friends remember those days, Summer Strike was at the old Clark Lanes right there off of Raritan Road and Central Avenue. And me and Tommy Tavallaro, out of the Linden area, we used to do many, many, many Summer Strike bowling events and just had a blast. Tom is just a fantastic individual, knows his bowling like nobody's business. And maybe if he's watching, we can reach out to him. Maybe he can come on and do some analyst work for us here if he's available. But just wanted to say a big shout out to Tommy Tavallaro. It's been a long time since I've seen Tommy. But we certainly had a great time calling those bowling matches on Summer Strike on TV3. Getting back to the present day, 2023, we are here live at Jersey Lanes. We have the Cougars, Cranford Cougars against the Roselle Park Panthers. Nick Rhett is up in the second frame. He goes nine spare. Rose opened up with a nine. Here's Will Town, essentially all even. Cougars down one, but we'll see what Will Town can do if he can double up here in the second. Nice looking shot there. Comes through the nose, trying to get a little help there. That one looked like he dropped the ball a little bit before the foul line. Derek for Roselle Park. This young man has a real nice shot too. If he dials that in, he's going to be a huge threat in this match. So here's Town for the spare. And that will call it a cover there. So Will Town goes nine spare in the second. Cougars up 10. And that young man, Derek, has a unique spare ball. He throws a backup ball basically for everything on the right-hand side of the lane. That's a lot of wrist movement. So here's Kisley coming off the open. Let's see what he can do here to come back. Nice looking, all 10 pins in the pit. Sweeping shot there. kicks out the 10. That's a strike, so the Cougars are up. I believe that says 18, but I think I need to get my glasses adjusted. It's a little tough to see the font size on our monitors here at Jersey Lanes. So we're giving you the full disclosure, Mikey. Full disclosure, buddy. All right, so Michael Martins is up here for Roselle Park. This young man had a nice game last first game. Owen Miller had the top score at 222. And I got to tell you, you know, analytics come into all sports these days, football, baseball, hockey, whatever. And it's even here in bowling. It's amazing how much data you can get from the automatic scoring. So Schusterman comes up with a strike. So a good looking, so far paying off here with the substitution for Amrose with Schusterman in the first spot. Here's Rose. A lot of spin on that ball, a lot of side spin on that ball. Just didn't have enough bite to grab the lane. So we'll see what Rose can do here if he can pick up this. For a lefty, it should be a fairly easy spare, but we'll see. So Owen Miller picks up his spare. And getting back to the analytical data, you know, we have ball speed, we have what the individual shot the first game, which is on top of what they're shooting there, which is great. Almost kicked out the 10. Good attempt there by Rose. He opens up in the third. Cougars down 17 here in early match play at Jersey Lanes in the second match. Again, Roselle Park won the first game, 845 to 800. Here comes Nikki Rett. Picks up seven. So looking to convert the spare, the 1-2-4, to continue the clean game. So Cougars up 13 now with Camilla Cordero up here for her seven-pin spare. Nice cover there. So here's Nick Rett, just slides by the head pin. So he opens up with a 45 now in the third. So let's see what Town can do here, coming off the nine spare mark in the second. So Will Town, again, if you're unfamiliar with bowling, you know, you give courtesy to either side of the lane, to your fellow competitors, fellow bowlers. That's why they'll just pause for a moment just to let that happen. So Caitlin Nickel is up here for the Roselle Park. Very nice, very, very nice cover there. So Caitlin picks up the spare there for Roselle Park. She's six spare in the third. So Will Town is on 32 for the Cougars, looking for eight spare. Here's Derek for Roselle Park. Couldn't get enough there off the sideboard. Let's see what Will Town can do. Can he pick up the spare? He does. Nice job by Will Town. He's clean through three, eight spare. And here comes Mike Kisley working on the strike. And this is such a unique backup ball. Wow, that thing just really took off him at the very end. Hit that oil as it breaks down. I don't think I've ever seen anybody throw a backup ball like that for a right-hander. Oh, wow. Again, friends, many using what was back in the day unconventional methods, but in bowling it doesn't make a difference just as long as you stay behind the foul line and the ball takes out all 10 pins. And this young man, Michael Martins, has got some shot. He goes through the nose. So Mike Kelly now on 32, he picks up the nine spare. So 3 out of 5 isn't bad. I'm channeling my inner late great Meatloaf. You know, 2 out of 3 ain't bad. But so we are, our Cougars are up 3. So Martins picks up the spare for Roselle Park. And we are going into the fourth frame here in game number 2 here at Jersey Lanes. So here we go. We've got Schusterman up here in the fourth, working on a strike. This could be a key shot. He comes through the nose. He's going to leave himself the 3-6-10. Owen Miller, this young man is on fire here so far. 222 in his first game. Has a strike here, 3 out of 4 marks. Here's Schusterman with the spare attempt. Real nice cover. So Drew is clean through 4. Cougars, according to this, are essentially even. It's kind of fun to look around the bowling center and see the old school kind of wooden chairs that are like nailed to the floor. I'm giving a lot of inside baseball language, but got to put some filler time in here as we're waiting. So Rose comes up here with a strike in the fourth. So Cougars down 2. All right, so here's Nick Rett. Crosses over, solid 10 pins in the pit there. So Cougars have 2 strikes in a row in the fourth. They're up 8. As Cordero for Roselle Park has got the split. The 4-6-7-10. Let's see how she plays this. That was a very, very good attempt there. So here's Will Town. Can we go 3 in a row here for the Cougars? Kind of that cascading waterfall effects type hit. So Will Town has got a 10 pin here for his spare. Here's Caitlin Nickel for Roselle Park. And she goes, looks to pick up her 3 pin here for the spare. All right, so Will Town working in the fourth, going for the 10-pin spare. That's going to slide off into the channel. This is an open frame for Will Town for the Cougars. Cougars still up 6 here. So Mike Kisley is up next. Let's see if he can make it 4 out of 5 with the marks for the Cougars. He goes right through the nose. He's going to leave himself the 6-7-10. Shot in the second, sped the ball up a little bit. Again, your oil patterns are starting to break down. So you need to make compensations. You need to make adjustments. And he picks up the smart play there to pick up the 2. So the oil patterns are going to break down for these big heavy-handed right-handers, that you're gonna have to slowly start to move to the left, move your board out a little bit further to the right. Boards 2 and 3, 4 maybe, send that thing sweeping, but you may want to more than likely move over about two boards at a time. You know, maybe do it an even number so you know how far your left foot has to come over on the approach. And maybe a little bit more speed. Again, as we get into that third game, the oil pattern is gonna completely start to break down. So the ball is really gonna start to hook, start to take off. So we're just waiting for Martins here to come up with the 9 spare on 32. It looks like we've got some lane issues here with the automatic pin setter not not functioning properly. So we just heard the call over the PA. Again, friends, it is just, it's amazing how much a bowling alley has not changed in, what, 100 years or however long bowling has been around. It is just amazing. Definitely a lot of old school things happening here in the bowling center. So let's see where we, so now 32 just went dark because they have to retrieve the pin. Retrieve the pin there. So let's see what we're gonna do here, and that should take care of that. And it leaves him the 4-10 split. We'll have to see if we can get a word with Coach Fila here after the second game. Sweeping hook. That was the way to play it, to go for that side, to go for that very far left side and do a ricochet into the 10 pin. So let's do a game reset coming into the halfway mark of this game number two. Cougars down 5. Here is Drew Schusterman. Having a clean game so far. Sends that ball way outside. Nice crossover strike. So Drew is having a real nice game here for the Cougars. He's the leading bowler so far for Cranford. So Cougars are up 15. Solid strike by Owen Miller. Solid strike. This young man is having some game, some match here. So Rose slides off to the left. He only gets 3. Leaves himself a fairly difficult spare. All right, so let's see what Rose can do. And again, friends, it's just there's a lot of courtesy here, which is great to see. Good sportsmanship. So here goes Rose in his spare attempt. Nice cover. Real nice way to pick yourself up there, especially working on a strike, or coming off a strike, I should say, in the fourth frame. So Nick Rett here. This is a key shot for the Cougars here. If he can double up, put some pressure on the Panthers halfway through the midpoint of this second match. He comes up with 9. Leaves himself a 2-pin. Here's Cordero going for the split, and nice cover. Nice cover by Camilla. So Cougars up 23. So here is Rett. He covers the spare, so real nice cover there by Nicky Rett. So far, the Cougars are clean through 3. So Will Town is up next for the Cougars. Let's see what Will Town can do. Crosses over. That's an interesting setup. 5-6-10. I gotta tell you, Mikey, it's starting to get that bowling alley food smell. It's starting to get hungry. I don't know, someone around us has got something that smells really good. I'm not sure, but back in the day, it was always the French fries sitting in the oil for like about 6 months. But hey, we were 15 and was able to burn off 6 month oil fries. Anyway, I digress here. Let's get back to the action. So Town opens up with 75 now in the fifth. Kisley waiting to bowl here as Martins for the Panthers. What a real nice looking shot by this young man. Wow, that is something else. Here comes Kisley. hits a little heavy, probably got away with not getting the split, the 4-9. Here's Martins for the spare. I'm impressed by this young bowler here with the spare shot, with that sweeping hook that he has on the first shot. He's able to compensate and not put as much rotation on the ball for the 10 pin. So Cougars down six with Kisley looking to spare in the fifth. So there we go, friends. So we are Cougars down five. Here's Schusterman. Good looking crossover strike there. That was a big key shot for Drew. A double here in the sixth. So really good looking shot for Drew Schusterman. Let's see what Owen Miller can do. He strikes again. He's got a triple. So that is Owen Miller has really been the thorn in the Cougars' side with a 222 in the first game and really kind of lighting it up here in this second match. All right, so Rose has the split and he is dealing with the 4-6-10. So for a lefty, again, you're going to want to go almost at you're going to go right at the 10. That's what he's going to go for. Let's see what happens. Hooks the 6 around the 10. So Rose opens up there. Let's see what Camilla can do for Roselle Park. And she has a going to work a 9 spare. So here's Nick Rett working a 9 spare in the fifth. Let's see what Nick can do here. Cougars down. Looks like the Cougars are down 10. So Rett leaves himself relatively easy 7 pin. Cordero opens up in the sixth. So as it stands now, looks like we are all square, depending on what Rett does here with the spare. Nice looking 7 pin. Just a little kiss. Little extra paint on the pins, as we used to say. So gets that one in the pit. So Cougars up one. Will Town looking to come back after the open. So Will Town has a solid 10 pin. We'll be shooting nines, going for the spare here. And Mikey, I see the individual that's got the French fries right behind us. All right, so Town covers here in the sixth. So Wernoski switches to the green ball, the backup ball he usually does, but he's using that for his first shot. Here's Kisley in the sixth. Sends that one wide, a little more speed. So Cougars down 23 at this point. So Wernoski picks up the spare for Roselle Park. So Cougars down 25. In the sixth. So let's see what Kisley can do here. Can he pick this spare up? And he does. So nice cover there by Mikey Kisley. So the Cougars down 21 now at this point. So Martins goes through the nose and gets a lot of luck there. He didn't even see it. He was walking back. He gets a lot of luck. Looked like the 5-pin came off the left sideboard, and the 4-pin, I should say, came off the sideboard, took out the 5, and then took out the 10. So it's going to leave him a relatively easy seven-pin spare. And he covers there. So let's see what game reset going into the seventh. Cougars down 40. This is the key shot in the match, friends. This is it for the Cougars to have any kind of a chance to come back and win this one. They're going to need Schusterman to go ahead and triple up. Let's see what happens on lane 32. Kind of sent that one a little bit too far to the inside. So he gets seven. Here's Owen Miller. He's dialed in now with four in a row. So Owen Miller is really having a nice game. Here comes Schusterman. Let's see if he can pick up the spare. And he does, covers that back pin. That's not an easy spare by any means whatsoever. So that was a good cover there coming off the double. So the Cougars are down 44 now in the seventh. Let's see what Ryan Rose can do for the Cougars. See if he can come back after that open frame in the sixth. Let's see what Rose can do. Sends that one a little more to the inside. So I see Rose is starting to make some minor adjustments as well. Again, friends, as the oil patterns break down here in the middle of the second match, by the second, third, fourth frame of the third match, these oil patterns are really going to start to take off. So these young bowlers are going to have to learn, you know, to make the adjustments and learn to see which way that they're going to make the adjustments to. So let's see what Rose can do now as we come in. Nice pickup there on the spare. So Cougars are down 44 at this point. So let's see what Rhett can do on his first shot in the seventh. Goes a little bit wide, leaves himself a tough spare. The 1-3-8-10. 1-3-8-10 right there. So with Caitlin here, she's got a good chance at that. Wow. Was looking good there for about three quarters of the lane. And again, as that oil pattern breaks down, the ball just bites and it just takes off on you. So Rhett there with, again, you can see Wernoski making big changes.
Pick it up, Derek. Pick it up.
Really a lot of loft in that ball for Derek. So let's see what Will Town can do as the Cougars open up in the seventh, Nick Rhett at least. So here is Will Town coming up in the seventh. Crosses over, can you get a little help? Nope, 10 pin stands. So here's Derek for Roselle Park with that backup ball, and that's going to slide to the right into the channel. All right, friends, so Cougars are down 46. Will Town, this is a crucial spare here, is going to have to pick up this. That ball slides off into the channel. So Cougars open up second straight here in the seventh. Down 46. And Martin's for the Panthers. He's getting a lot of action. I think he needs to really stick with looking at the lane, because every time he turns around, he's not quite sure what he ends up with. But so Kisley has a split, I should say. The 6-7, unique looking split here. And again, as these oil patterns change, you need to make the adjustments. So Martins picks up the spare. Cougars, they're down 49. Oh, good attempt there by Kisley for the spare. All right, so we're going into the eighth here. Cougars need to start striking if they want to have any chance of coming back to win this match. And there it is. There's the first one by Schusterman. So Drew having a real nice game. 155 already through the eighth. Let's see what Owen Miller can do. Working on four. Looking for five in a row. Comes up a little bit short, but a nice effort there. Four in a row. So here's Ryan Rose. Almost slipped over the foul line. Let's see if he can get some action off that. Leaves himself the five pin. Kind of stuck at the line a little bit and then almost came across the foul line. Let's see what Miller can do here. He picks up the spare. So Miller has 166 through eight. He is the high bowler for both squads. Although Schusterman is giving a run for his money there. With 155 through eight. Let's see what Rose can do now. And a nice pickup there by Ryan Rose. So Rose goes nine spare, second spare mark in a row. Let's see what Camilla for Roselle Park can do. Gets nine. All right, so let's see what Nick Rett does. I think he may need to speed up the ball just slightly. He's moved over a little bit by a board or two to the right, and that's exactly what he does, is speed up the ball. And he's gonna leave himself the six pin. That ball was at 16 miles per hour, so analytics don't lie, and they're telling us that definitely sped up the ball on that shot. So Camilla opens up there for the Panthers. Cougars down 47, and now Rhett just slides by the left of that six pin. So let's see if Will Town can pick him up. That oil pattern is breaking down. Crosses over. Get him any way you can, Willie. All right, so Town has a strike in the eighth. Cougars down 46 now, but Cougars are ahead by two bowlers. They've just turned off lanes 29 and 30 now as the Roselle Rams finish their game play for the afternoon. So let's see what Kisley can do. Sped the ball up a little bit. Nice. There you go. So he made the adjustment a little bit faster on that shot and managed to send it out a little bit further to the right. So Derek scores. He strikes here in the eighth. Cougars down 47 at this point. So Cougars are down 47 now going into the foundation frame. So now we're just waiting for Roselle Park to finish out the bottom half of the eighth. As Martin's working on a nine spare. Sends that ball way outside. Just shreds the pins. And that's what I was talking about, friends, is that you have to make those adjustments. That ball was very close to the channel, and you can see how far back that ball came back. So Schusterman now working on a strike. This is a key strike. The Cougars have to have this here. He goes through the head pin and leaves himself 3-10. Owen Miller goes through the head pin himself for Roselle. This young bowler here is having a really nice day. Let's see if he can pick up the split. Very nice cover by Schusterman. So Schusterman comes in. Bruce Schusterman comes in, take over the top spot and putting up a 175 so far through nine. So let's see what Ryan Rose can do up here for the Cougars. in the second spot in the ninth frame. So Camila Cordero is up for the Panthers. She's going to do six there. So Rose just waiting for the JV squad to finish up there on 33. Let's see what Rose can do. Saws the rack in half. Unbelievable. Good looking shot by Ryan Rose. So that's what the Cougars needed. Down 51. And Camilla just missed getting that spare. So Cougars down 54 now. Let's see what Nick Rett can do. We need a strike there. There it is. All right, so there you go. So we got two strikes in a row for the Cougars. This is another key shot from Town. If he can double up, here in the ninth, Caitlin Nickel puts together a strike. And there's the double there by Will. So Cougars still hanging around now, down 44. Here comes Wernoski. Derek just, just literally sawed that in half. Unbelievable. That was like puppet mastery. He was pulling the strings on those pins. That was impressive. Very impressive there. All right, see what Mike Kisley can do. He strikes. So the Cougars setting themselves up really nicely here in the foundation ninth. So Kisley has the double. Town has the double going into the 10th. Rose and Rett both have strikes going into the ninth. Michael Martin's there strikes for his double. The old PA system at the bowling alley in like the old Clark Lanes days. AT&T Midnight League, you're ready for practice. All right, so Schusterman here in the 10th has got double wood. 3-9. So now Cougars are down 48. Here comes Miller. Solid pocket hit, leaves the solid 10. Let's see what Schusterman can do here. Sends that one a little bit faster, and he chops it off. He chops off the three. So real nice game, though, by Drew Schusterman. 192 for the Cougars. Real solid performance there by Drew. So let's see what Owen Miller does. He picks up the spare. So Cougars down 66 now, but Cougars have a lot of X's on the board. Let's see what Ryan Rose can do. Sends that one a little bit wide. So he's going to leave himself the one. So he leaves himself, 1-3-5-8. Here's Owen Miller. Gets a 9, so he goes in. He finishes out at 212. So this young man has got 222, 212. Could be going for that 600 series. Good cover there by Ryan Rose. Good looking cover. So again, every pin here counts. They're down 55, the Cougars, with Rett working with a strike in the ninth. A double for Town, a double for Kisley in the ninth and tenth. So the Cougars have a good foundation to come back and take this game away from Roselle Park. So let's see what Ryan Rose, just sent it right down the middle. Get as many pins as you can. There you go. There you got 9 pins. So Rose finishes up at 158. We got the 10th frame reset. Camila Cordero shooting her spare, slides past the spare. So she ends up with 138. All right, so Nick Rett, this is a key shot, down 55. Goes right through the nose. So he comes up with a split. Again, Cougars are 6-4 on the year. So Cougar is down 41. You gotta go for the pin count. So Rett slides off into the channel. He ends up at 140. So our score is now Schusterman 192, Rose 158. Nick Rett at 140. So if the Cougars want to have any chance of winning this match, you're going to have to strike here. So here's Town looking for the triple. He goes through the nose. So Cougars down 40, but you've got 4-5 for Roselle with working on doubles. So Will Town looking to pick the spare up, slides by. He goes 8-out. So Cougars down 46 at this point, but so Caitlin Nickel comes up with 177. Derek Ornosky is shooting a double going into the 10th. Here's Mike Kisley. Kisley has to strike in order for the Cougars to even think about it, and I think it's already out of contention. So a solid pocket shot there with the triple for Kisley. Brings that down to 16. So Wernoski has the 6-10 to contend with it with his spare. So let's see if Kisley can go 4 in a row. So put a lot of pressure on Michael Martins for the Panthers. He comes up with 8. So Cougars down 24, and for the most part, this one is over, and this is going to go to Roselle Park. And there's that backup ball again. Unbelievable the way he throws that. So Cougars finish up with 8:23. So we got Schusterman 192, Rose 158, Rett 140, Town at 158, and Kisley at 175. And Wernoski just adds to that total, comes in at 179. So Miller at 212, Cordero 138, Nickel at 177, Wernoski 179, and we'll just see how much more that Roselle can add to the pin count and the total pins for a second match victory here at Jersey Lanes. Just rips the rack apart for the triple. And you can see how Mike has moved. He's moved at least 3 to 4 boards to the left. So let's see if he can put 4 in a row now. Sends that ball way outside. Huge turn. There's 4 in a row. Mike is dialed in now. 201 with one more in the 10th. Looking for a 5-bagger here to finish it out and just add to the pin count. So we're just waiting here for Martins to finish up in the 10th. See if he can put together 6 in a row. Sends it wide. He ends up with a 208. So real nice game there. Two 200 games for the Panthers. And they're going to win it here 9-14, 8-23. So Cougars go down in the second match as well. So quick battery change here. quick battery change, and we're getting set for match three. So it looks like the Cougars are going to keep the same lineup. Schusterman, Rose, Rhett, Town, and Kissley. So here's Schusterman now up in the first. Sends that ball way to the left and just gets one. All right, so friends, we are with Cranford Cougar Varsity Sports Action on Cranford TV 35. I want to thank you for tuning us in here on TV 35. Don Smith, old Mikey here, our camera operator at Jersey Lanes in beautiful Linden here in Union County. It's a Union County matchup. Cranford Cougars here against the Roselle Park Panthers. And we are in our third game. Cougars went down in the first two matches. And are more than likely, if my math is correct, they're probably down on total pins by, I would say, close to 150 or more. So it's going to be an uphill battle to try to get total pin count. But you see if we can pick up 2 points now for the win in this third game and prevent Roselle Park from the clean sweep. So Schusterman goes eight and out. Here's Rose. Nice sweeping strike there for Rose. So what the analytics do now is that they're just adding total pin count now instead of just the three games. So Miller for the Panthers at 434. That was a solid strike by Nick Rhett. Just tore the pins apart. You can see you can see Rhett a little frustrated with things and just definitely getting aggressive there with that ball. 18.6 miles per hour. So that's the fastest I think I've seen anybody throw a ball today. So that ball just slips off of Will Town's hand and into the channel. So, you know, we've got a lot of factors here, friends. You know, the lanes are breaking down, the oil patterns. You know, we're getting later into the afternoon, and these young student athletes have been in school all day. So a little bit of fatigue will be setting in here now. So Town picks himself up with the spares. That's a good way to do it. After the channel shot, we'll pick that up here. So Warnoski opens up there in the first. So let's see what Martins can do for the Panthers. And Kissley is up next. Slid by just a little bit there. Just like he didn't get enough rotation on the ball to let it go. But Martins is way out to the right. He's dialed in now, this young man. He is totally dialed in. He is dialed in. So all right, so let's see what Kissley can do now. Good attempt at this, almost. So Kissley now opens up in the ninth. In the first frame. So we're waiting for Roselle Park to start off. Let's see here. Schusterman is up in the second. He goes through the nose there, and he's going to leave himself a difficult spare to pick up. It's the 3-9-10. Owen Miller has got a lot of rotation on that ball. He comes up with a 9. All right, so Owen Miller opens up here for Panthers. Schusterman opened as well, so Rose looking to double up here. Looks like he's made a bit of an adjustment as well and looking for a little help. Can he get it? Here's Cordero with her first shot in the second frame. That's a strike for Camilla. So let's see if Ryan Rose can pick up the spare. Good looking spare there by Ryan Rose in the second frame. So Cougars up one here. Again, we're very early in action in our third game. If you're just joining us, we thank you so much for dialing us up here on TV 35 on Comcast as well as Verizon. Thank you so much for tuning in with us here. Don Smith, old Mikey on the camera here at Jersey Lanes in Linden for Cranford Varsity High School Sports here on TV 35 in a bowling contest between the Cougars and Roselle Park Panthers. Roselle Park took the first two games, won the first game by 45, a little over about 80 or 90, as I missed the pin count there at the very end. So they're well up in total pins, won the first two games. So Rhett opened up with five there in the second. Here comes Town, his first shot. He's got a seven spare working. So Michael Martin's here looking to double up. He is almost in the channel of the opposing lane. Just tears the rack apart. So Will Town chops off the one off of the three and the sixth. So Cougars down 22. I'm real impressed by Michael Martin's, absolutely. He's got it dialed in with that spare shot, you know, coming from the big hook on the first shot. So here's Kisley for the Cougars, goes through the nose, leaves himself 6'10". Let's see what Schusterman can do to come back after the two opens. Crosses over, a little help, there we go, trips out the five. So Schusterman picks up the strike here in the third. Let's see what Kisley can do. He slides by the spare. So let's see what Ryan Rose can do here. Crosses over, can he get a little help? Does not. So Ryan Rose here on lane 31 looking for the pickup of the eight pin. Just gets it. A little extra coat of paint on that pin, Mikey. That's all that matters. So we're halfway through the third frame in our third match. And let's bring you in here, Mike. Your thoughts here, bud, about what
we've seen
so far?
Same as before. You know, it's very exciting to watch. That's all I got.
That's all he got. That's all Mikey's got. He's a man of few words, so. So it's definitely fairly fast paced. So Red has a split going into the third frame. So that's like the picket fences here for Nick Rhett. Let's see what we can do. Let's see. Gets one. So Rhett opens up here in the third. So here's Will Town, crosses over, and wow, that's a tough break for Will Town. That is a 3-7-10, but more makeable, obviously, than the 7-10 if it stood alone. So the idea here is to go as hard as you can. So the ball takes out the 10, the ball clips the 3, and he's going right for it. If he can hook it a little bit more, he had the right idea. So Cougars there in the middle of the lineup. A little bit of a rough go there with two opens. Let's see what Kisley can do here to come off the open in the second. That one, he spit it up a little bit, gets a sweeper pin. He saws off the six pin. And even he can't believe that one was a strike. So Kisley strikes here in the 10th. Cougars down 25, heading into the fourth frame. So now Roselle Park just finishing out their fourth bowler here in the third frame. So it's going to be a couple of minutes here before the Cougars finish out, get into the fourth. That backup ball there by Derek is something else. That is something else. A lot of wrist strength involved in that. So Martin's just tears apart the rack again. This guy's dialed in too. So Schusterman now up on 32, as Owen Miller will be up here on 31. So here's Schusterman. Crosses over. Doesn't get any help from a messenger pin. Let's see what Owen Miller does. High loft, lots of speed. I'm kind of thinking that either he may have switched to a lighter ball. That's what it looks like to me. So Schusterman gets the 6-10, picks that up. So Miller picks up the spare. All right, so let's see what Ryan Rose can do now in the fourth. He takes apart the rack, looking for a little help against the sideboard for the 10. Comes up a little bit short. So far, Ryan Rose is clean. You love the vibe with the PA system here in the bowling center. Really, really brings back a lot of memories. Cranford Bowling League had been around for a long, long time. We bowled at Clark Lanes. You had to either work or live in Cranford. And really popular league. I don't know if that's still in existence anywhere. Maybe here at Jersey Lanes, but. Cranford Bowling League, I bowled in that for a number of years. Had a lot of fun Friday night bowling. All right, so let's come back to 2023 and not 1993. We'll talk to you about Nicky Red here going for his 9 spare pickup. And he picks that one up. So nice spare there by Rhett. Cougars down 49. And a bit of a hole here early on in this third match. So here's Will Town, sends that one really wide, crosses over and gets the help. Picks himself up after the open frame. So Schusterman there, he looks like he switched to his spare ball, which may be a lighter ball. Just ripped the rack apart, really sent that one out way right. And there's Kisley now with a split. So again, friends, as these lanes are breaking down, you have to make adjustments. As you'll see Mikey here with Michael Martins, his left foot is almost in the opposing lane. That's how far to the right he has moved his shot. So Kisley here is going to be setting up for a 5-7 split attempt. It's going to go right for it and comes up a little bit short. So the Cougars are in a pretty deep hole here going into the midway point of this third match, down 57. And Martins converts the spare. So, friends, here we go. We've got Schusterman 47 through 4, Rose with 67, Rhett with 39, Town with 42, and Kisley with 45. So we're heading into the halfway point of this match. Once again, we thank you so much for dialing us up here on Channel 35 on Comcast and Verizon. Don Smith along with Mikey here on the camera, bringing all the great bowling action here from Jersey Lanes in beautiful Linden here in Union County. Union County matchup, friends, Roselle Park and Cranford. Roselle Park and Cranford have an enormous lengthy history of a rivalry, especially in wrestling and many other varsity sports at Cranford High School. And so far, Roselle Park is up 2-0. And this young bowler here, Owen Miller, is having some afternoon. So here is Schusterman with the attempt. Good looking attempt there for the split. He opens up there in the fifth, so he gets 63. All right, so Rose is up here in the fifth. Let's see what he can do. He sends that one straight down the center, crosses over, solid strike. So you take it one shot at a time and see if the Cougars can pull themselves out of this pretty deep deficit here halfway through this third matchup. So we've got some lane issues on 32 again. So Nick Rhett is up, solid strike for Nicky here in the fifth. So Cougars down just 35, but the Cougars are ahead by two bowlers at this point. So here's Will Town looking to double up, crosses over, looks for a little help, kicks out the 9-pin, so leaves himself a relatively easy 10-pin spare. So Cordero is up with her first shot in the fifth. So Town opened up, he missed the 10 pin. Cordero opens up here in the fifth. Let's see what Kisley can do to redeem himself here after that open frame with a split. And he just tears the rack apart. So good looking job there by Mikey Kisley to come back after that open frame in the fourth. Thank you. So it's going to be a couple minutes here before the Cougars get back on the lanes. They were just a bit of a head. We had a little mechanical issue on 32. So let's see where we're at now. Wernoski coming up here in the fifth. Sends that one wide, goes through the nose. So we're just waiting for Wernoski to finish out. That's a nice looking shot. Picks up the eight spare there, and here comes Martins, who's just been on a tear through this contest. Cougars down 51 here at the midway point of match three. And he's going to leave himself the 3-6. So a little, I don't know what happened there. I don't know if it's the, I guess it's the ball return. I guess they don't have enough space on the ball return. And just picks up the spare there. So Martins picks up the spare. Very, very nice. So Cougars now going to the sixth frame down a bunch. Down 69 pins here going into the sixth frame. Cougars are going to need some strikes fairly soon to stay in this one. So Schusterman up here on 32. He goes eight spare attempt now. Here's Miller for the Panthers. He's dialed in. He doubles up here in the sixth. And you can see that ball was a lot faster than the previous couple shots. And that's what you got to do. Either you move or you throw the ball a little bit faster to compensate for that oil pattern breakdown. So Schusterman opens up here nine and out. He goes nine and out. So we're looking at Rose now, hopefully to double. Cougars absolutely need this double to really stay in this contest. He gets six. So they both of the bowlers have the exact same spare attempt coming up. So let's see what Rose can do here. Can he pick up the spare? And he does. So nice spare cover there by Ryan Rose. So Nick Rett is up here in the sixth. What kind of hasn't really changed in the last 40 years or whatever is the PA system. Still sounds the same way. So nice pickup there by Nick Rett. Handing out some rings here for the 300 game. So very well deserved there with the 300 ring. That has got to be one of the toughest thing for an amateur bowler to do is the 300 game. I mean, I came close. I had the first 10 in a row out of 12. And, you know, you're basically standing up there literally with rubber bands for legs, you know, when it gets to that point. Granted, mine was in a practice. It was not in a tournament. But nonetheless, I still shot 277. And that's still the high total for me. I think my high total was 614 for a three-game set. Another good cover there by Will Town. So I think we're having some issues with the lane here on 31. I'm not sure if the ball return didn't send the ball back or what's going on here. But we're still waiting for Roselle Park to cut through the sixth frame. So Kisley just tears the rack apart there. He doubles up going into the sixth. So again, at this point, Cougars down 16, but Roselle Park is still four bowlers that haven't even bowled yet with the issues on lane 31. So I believe that the ball, oh no, it looks like we have the ball back. There we go. Is going to be Cordero opens up here in the sixth. So Caitlin is up here for Roselle Park. She gets a little action, mixed action there. So looking at seven spare for her. So a little game reset here. Cougars and Roselle Park Panthers in a bit of a one-sided affair for Roselle Park, winning the first two games handily. We're in our third final match, halfway through, going into the seventh frame now. We're still finishing up the sixth for Roselle Park. We had some mechanical issues on the lane. So Derek Wernoski hits up on the Brooklyn side. So now Martins is going to finish out the sixth here. He's working on an eight spare. And again, look how far to the left he is. Absolutely, he's in the channel practically. And he's just tearing the rack apart. That is some confidence right there, some strength, some power. Going to see a lot of that young bowler, Michael Martins. All right, so now we're going to reset it here. Cougars are down 69. Down 69 pins with Schusterman up in the seventh. Ball didn't come back enough for Drew. He's going to leave himself the 1-2-4-5. Owen Miller working on a double there, looking for some mixed action, gets nine. So Schusterman picks up the spare. He's got 82 through seven. So here is Rose, pocket hit, doesn't get any help. So the Cougars are down 68. So Ryan Rose now up in the seventh, looking for a nine spare, and he's going to slide by to the right. So Cordero is coming up here for the Panthers. So let's see what Roselle Park can do here. Crosses over, crossover strike there for Roselle Park. So Nick Rett. So Nick Rett shooting nine attempts spare. He's going to slide by to the left. So Cougar is in a big, big deficit here, minus 80. So a nice pocket strike there for Will Town. And Mike Kisley, this is an important shot here. If he can triple up, maybe give him a little bit of ray of hope at the end of the tunnel here. But so Wernoski doubles up there after making some adjustments. Let's see what Kisley can do. Sends that out to about 4-8, crosses over and hits the pretty much a solid head pin hit. So there's Kisley, picks up the spare. So Martins picks up the spare. We're going into the eighth frame now. So here's Shusterin going to come up in the eighth. And here is Miller for his first shot. Solid strike there. This young bowler is really having one heck of an afternoon. So we're just waiting for Shusterman to come up here in the eighth. Cougars down 92. Pretty heavy deficit to work themselves out of. Let's see what Shusterman can do here on lane 32. Sends it wide, crosses over, doesn't get the action looking for. He's looking for, I should say. Leaves the 3-6-9. Good cover there by Drew Shusterman. So outstanding cover by Drew. And a nice cover there by Camilla Cordero for the Panthers. Real nice spare shot there by Camilla. So we've got Rose here with 7 spare now, working in the eighth. Let's see if Rose can pick up the spare. And he chops off the 1 and the 3 off the 6. All right, so Nick Rett is up next. Crosses over and gets a little action. He does. Trips out the head pin there for the strike. So Will Town. So Will Town now was on a strike, his 8 working spare. So I just love this backup ball by Drew. So close there, just missed it, opens up. So Cougars down 106 in a real, real big hole now. So Will Town now getting set for his spare attempt on the 5-9. And he gets up the spare. So another mark for the Cougars, down 102. They're going to need a lot more X's than slashes. Wow. That is some ball by Michael Martins. Unbelievable. The rotation, the strength, the power. You're going to see a lot of good things from that young bowler. So here's Mike Kisley. Can get the messenger. Just missed. So he'll be shooting his 10 pin here for the spare. Here's Shusterman up in the ninth. Sends that one a little bit heavy. And he's going to leave himself the 6-10. So Kisley hangs on for the 10, for the spare on the 10 pin. So Cougar is down 187. Down 87. But Owen Miller is working on a strike in the eighth. See if he doubles up. Good looking shot, goes through the nose. He'll leave the 7 pin. So here's Ryan Rose in the ninth. He just lets that one slide by a little bit. He has the 1-3-6 to contend with here. So the Cougars down 96. If you're just joining us here on TV 35, thank you so much for tuning us in here towards the end of our varsity bowling matchup between the Cougars and the Roselle Park Panthers. Don Smith along with Mikey here on the camera. Good looking pickup there by Ryan Rose for the spare. For the spare here in the ninth. Roselle Park won fairly handily both matches, the first and second, and are big here in the third. So let's see what Rhett can do here to pick up the spare. He flattens the ball out. He's going to pick that up handily. So go 8 spare now in the ninth. So Cordero picks up her spare in the ninth. And Will Town leaves himself a relatively easy 3 pin. See what Town can do here to pick up the spare. He does. So he picks up the 3 pin. Here comes Kisley up in the ninth. See what Kisley can do now. Down 87 pins. Sends that one really wide, a lot of rotation, picks up the on the O strike. So good setup for the foundation there for the 10th. So Cougar is down 76 now. For Warnoski to pick up the spare, which he does. So let's see what Michael Martins can do. He is almost in the opposite lane. Unbelievable power. It was almost too much power. Almost too much power leaves the solid 9. Quite frankly, don't honestly see too many solid 9 pins, but here you do. And he picks that up. So we're in the final stretch here for the Cougars, down 97 going into the 10th with a clean frame there in the 8th. So Schusterman comes up with 7. So let's see what Miller can do. His first ball in the 10th. Goes through the nose and it leaves himself the 6-10. So Schusterman has 131. Cougars down almost 100, 99. Let's see what Schusterman can do. And he just chops off that, just chops it off there. So See what Miller can do here for the spare. And he picks up the 6-10. So Schusterman comes up with it 133. Here's Rose. He picks up 6. See what Miller can do to add to his totals. He'll end up with 192. And let's see what his totals are for the three games, if it puts it up. Should.
No, that's bad.
So it looks like a 626, so really great, great three-game set for Owen Miller for Roselle Park. So Nick Rett is up next here as Ryan Rhodes opens up with 148 there and out. So let's see what Nick Rett can do here to finish things off. Nice job there by Camilla. Made the adjustment there for the double in the 10th. So Rhett opens up as well for 140. Cougars down 109. And it's pretty much over at this point for Cranford. It is done. Let's see what Town can do. He'll cross over and pick up the strike. Camila Cordero puts up a nice 169. Cougars down 97 with Town working on a strike in the first shot in the 10th. Leaves himself the 5-pin. So we're just wrapping up things here. Pretty much over for the Cougars. They're going to drop all three games and total pins here to the Panthers. So here's Will Town looking to slides by in the spare. So he opens up strike 158. So here is Warnoski with goes through the head pin, leaves himself a split. So Cougars down 113 as this one is just basically just for the books at this point. So Kisley strikes there for the double. Oh, he's going to get this. He's going to get this. Nice cover there with the backup ball. Wow. On the 3-10. Impressive. So let's see if Mike Kisley here can put this together for a triple. If you have to see the turkey come out, let's see if it'll come out. And he goes right through the nose. So he's going to leave himself the 4-6-7-10. Huge arc there for Derek, I should say. He ends up with 179. And Kisley here is going to add more than likely two to end with 177. And he does. He gets the two there. So Cougars end up here this afternoon in the third game, 7:56. So we have Schusterman at 133, Rose 148, 140 for Rhett, Town 158, and Kissley at 177. So with a 7:56, Cougars go down all three games as well as total pins here this afternoon at Jersey Lanes as we're just wrapping up things. Just waiting for Roselle Park to finish out the final totals for Martins here. Shooting strike frame 10 going into 11 with a 188. Sends that ball really wide. Solid strike there with the double. 198 there. So the teams here are wrapping up. So let's see what the final totals will be once we're finished up here. So Miller 192, Cordero 169, Nickel at 135, again Nickel at 135, and Wernoski at 179, and Martins finishes it out with a triple with a 208. So real nice, great match there. Shoots a 602. Miller shoots 626. Kissley at a 500 series, 503. 476 for Rose. Rhett at 429 and 480 for Town. So there we go, friends. Looks like we're just going to wrap things up here from Jersey Lanes. Once again, you're watching Cranford Cougar Varsity Sports on Cranford TV 35. I want to thank station manager Ed Davenport, Chris Hoffman, Mikey here on the camera here at Jersey Lanes. So once again, the final score is the Cranford Cougars get swept by the Roselle Park Panthers. Three games to none and in total pins. So the Cougars will fall to 6-5 on the season to the Roselle Park Panthers. Some real nice bowling here by the Roselle Park Panthers. And Drew Schusterman came into that second game, really gave the Cougars a bit of a lift, but just wasn't enough here this afternoon at Jersey Lanes. So for Mike, I'm Don Smith for Cranford TV 35. We say thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.